Swapsy gonna be playing that Destruction Warlock and Chaz on that Restoration Druid. And I'm really curious to see if Swapsy is going to be playing that Demonic Portal instead of that Mortal Coil, because that's what Chanimal did yesterday in their games against Method Orange to bring them victory.
All right, we're gonna find out very shortly if we do see that green little circle going down on the ground. We know the Swapsy did go for that option. If we see those Mortal Coils flying, we know he went with the more standard cookie cutter build. He's gonna be opening right now Method Black, first wild card game, and you can vote in the chat and let us know who you think is gonna be able to take this series.
Yeah, it's been a long time since we've seen Waz on Rogue, and now it's definitely a pleasant surprise. Method Black tagging in Waz, bringing in that Rogue Lock Druid composition, and we've seen this do quite well against the Windwalker Death Knight, although I have to say, I still feel like Wildcard Gaming, if they play this matchup right, they still have an advantage.
Yeah, so when we've seen Wildcard Gaming go head-to-head with Method Black in previous weeks, Wildcard Gaming have crafted this Windwalker Death Knight Mistweaver, and Method Black really had no response to it. We saw them trying any composition under the sun. This time, deciding to lead with the blind pick with the Destruction Warlock Assassination Rogue. We saw success from The Move in North America yesterday in this matchup, but I would say that Never Lucky's Windwalker Death Knight is not on the same caliber as Wildcard Gaming's, so potentially it's not the perfect answer. Maybe it's better than everything that they have. I'm surprised that they didn't lock in a Mage Warlock composition, since we saw that completely dismantle Method Orange Cleave setups. But so far, it's pretty evenly fought now, with mana slightly in favor of Wildcard Gaming. However, cooldowns falling behind. Blizzo a vulnerability. Waz with Smoke Bomb available. Very curious to see if Waz decides to make a move in that regard. Instead, actually just attacking Looney, trying to create pressure in multiple places. And also by attacking the healer, he can avoid getting leg swept. Ultimately walking into it there, getting gripped, sorry. And now Swapsy gets bursted. Triple crowd control set up from Wildcard Gaming. Swapsy really taking a beating. Then the double Mortal Coils to deflect. You always want to try and crowd control a Mistweaver during Way of the Crane, and methods that Method Black have to do that is the Mortal Coil, the Fear, the Kidney Shot, and the Blind or a Bash. In that situation, they weren't able to get a Fear, so Swapsy took a lot more damage than normal.
Uh-oh.
But now Blizzo on the back foot. This is the vulnerability that has kind of made itself apparent now that he has no personal defensive cooldowns. Still waiting for that Kidney Shot Smoke Bomb. Looney's out of position if Waz decides to go for it. I'm surprised that he hasn't already.
Yeah, definitely. Blizzo could be in some trouble. No touch of karma. Caught into a Kidney Shot without his Gladiator's Medallion, but Anti-Magic Zone trades out from Z-Buy, and that will ultimately keep Blizzo alive. But they didn't really get any cooldowns for Method Black. So Method Black, Waz, he still has a Vendetta available coming up in a few seconds, and that's going to be an opportunity for him to push through and maybe take Blizzo down before he can get that touch of karma off. If they can land a full Kidney Shot with the Smoke Bomb, Method Black could close out this game.
Another Kidney Shot with Vendetta, and they didn't Smoke Bomb. I really don't know what situation Waz is waiting for. I mean, now Touch of Karma has been traded out, but he's been sitting on this Smoke Bomb when an enemy player had no Glider's Medallion for 2 minutes. That was a huge opening that Method Black have missed. Swapsy now on the back foot. Tons of pressure being tossed at him. Mana not looking great either for Method Black's, assuming that Wildcard Gaming can deny drinks. Blizzo gets stun locked again. There's the Glider's Medallion and Diffuse Magic. So a lot of cooldowns exchanged all at once, and Method Black have set up the exact same situation that they had previously, where they can drop an Infernal and go for a Smoke Bomb play, trying crowd control Looney as he moves into the Smoke Bomb. I think that strategy would be most effective before dampening. Waz gets swapped too, caught into a triple stun. Swapsy, why would they go for a Shadow Fury onto the DPS? Now they have to wait for the Kidney Shot diminishing return. Swapsy likely to use the Demonic Gateway to escape the Abomination. Maybe it's still on cooldown. I'm surprised to not see him try and just run away from it. Instead, going for the Infernal. Well-placed Cataclysm. That's going to get Immolate on all of these ghouls, and that's going to allow Swapsy to generate Soul Shards much more rapidly, which allows him to pump out Chaos Bolts. See if Swapsy can get some Chaos Bolts out. Smoke Bomb gets dropped. Blizzo is able to escape. Swapsy was unable to cast. Z-Pi getting pressured. Surprisingly large amount of pressure onto Z-Pi here before dampening.
Yeah, and Chaz, I think he's actually sitting down for a drink. If he can get a drink here, Method Black, they were way behind on mana. Did manage to sip for a little bit, regenerate some of that mana. Z-Pi still low, Blizzo as well. Looney trying to play catch up here with the Way of the Crane, throwing some added damage. Paralysis on Chaz, the crowd control begins. Can they get the unending resolve from Swapsy, that major defensive cooldown? Swapsy doesn't want to use it too late, but might be able to hold on pre-dampening with Iron Bark. That Destruction Warlock is going to be incredibly tanky.
by getting bursted. Mana is evening out. It's anyone's match here as we get closer to dampening. Looney's going to want to hold on to as much mana as possible to use Way of the Crane. Currently crowd controlling up Chaz. This is a good opportunity to burst down Swapsy and get an unending resolve, but it's actually Zipai who's falling behind. Chaos Bolts connect. Life Cocoon denies the kill for now, but even still, they've managed to crack through that cocoon. Perhaps a very well-polished Rogue Warlock Druid is the answer to the Windwalker Death Knights. It's still a little bit too close to call, but their pressure is certainly mounting. Now we see Swapsy getting pressured, unending resolve exchanged for that Abomination, which is a fair trade. Blizzo and Swapsy both under fire.
Yep, Blizzo Trinkets out. Gladiator's Medallion no longer available, as well as the Diffused Magic. Luckily, still has a touch of Karma, but a huge Chaos Bolt connecting from Swapsy. Now Blizzo, he's vulnerable. Looney doesn't have a Trinket. He doesn't have the Life Cocoon either, so there's really no safety net for Wildcard Gaming, but they're still pushing through. They want to try to take Swapsy down. The pressure from Wildcard Gaming this matchup has been so immense, better than any other Windwalker Death Knight I've really seen. Blizzard with that Tiger Eye Blue specialization has been able to shred through that Destruction Warlock defense, but now he's vulnerable with a bash onto Looney. Blizzard could potentially fall, but he's still just going for it.
A swap and drop. Waz gets swapped to and bursted, barely stays alive. Chaz is totally tapped on mana, caught in crowd control. Blizzo with limited defense. Looney needs to save him desperately, but he's caught in crowd control. Blizzo portals nowhere. Big mistake. Mortal Coil connects. Swapsy trying to fear up, potentially Looney not able to find, but a kidney shot, no smoke bomb. Maybe just damage will kill him. Looney needs to make a decision. Does he Life Cocoon and risk getting spell locked? It looks like he's trying to go for the riskier line and not use that Life Cocoon just yet. Waz is still falling behind. Both members of Method Black in trouble as Chaz is crowd control chained into the ground. Desperate moves for Swapsy to try and get Blizzo off his back. Looney gets spell locked. Could be an opportunity for Method Black to bounce back. How much damage can they do? The Abomination has entered the arena. Vendetta is shortly available. It's down to the wire.
Yeah, definitely. Blizzo very vulnerable. Chaz using his Innervate. Doesn't really have too much mana left to work with. He needs to try to keep Swapsy and Waz stable. Infernals get dropped down. Good counter pressure. Diffuse Magic traded out by Blizzard to stay alive. He has a few seconds left on that Touch of Karma, but he's just going for it. Double leg sweep once again. Big pressure. Blizzo messes up his port two times in a row. Big throws from Blizzo. Oh no, I was going to compliment him on his defensive play, but twice in a row he messes up his...
To get to see if Method Black is going to be able to get their revenge. Last time they went against Wildcard Gaming, it was in two series last week. They couldn't pull a single game off of them. It was 7-0 in favor of Wildcard Gaming. Wildcard Gaming taking the entire tournament. They want to do it again, but they're on the back foot. Method Black trying to stop them in their tracks.
And this is the best part of watching Method Black go head-to-head with Wildcard Gaming week after week, is that maybe one of them gets the upper hand on one given week, but then the other team has figured out something new to be able to overcome that adversity. And they are definitely competitive rivals, to say the least. And when they move forward to the spring finals in that LAN event, if I'm one of the North American teams in that third place and fourth seed to face them in the first round, I think I'm a little bit more than intimidated. Swapsy currently positioned on his Demonic Gateway. He's waiting for Zipai to unleash that Raze Abomination. As soon as that giant undead creature enters the battlefield, it's likely that we see Swapsy use the Demonic Gateway to escape from it, as it does move so slowly. Waz sets up a swap on a Zipai. That stun on Swapsy was 1 second too late. Some small mistakes by Wildcard Gaming, and facing down Method Black, you really can't afford too many of those.
Yeah, definitely a really punishing team here from Wildcard Gaming. What is Blizzo going to do? Doesn't have the Touch of Karma, and it looks like Swapsy still has his Dark Soul as well as Vendetta available for Waz. So Method Black, at some point, they can make a huge offensive push. But like I said in the last game, Wildcard Gaming, they've been doing a really good job getting pressure on the Swapsy, and I really feel like a lot of that is off the back of Blizzo with that Tiger Eye Brew specialization. Big pressure now onto Zipai. Dark Soul gets traded up by Swapsy. Looney has to play catch up. He has the Life Cocoon as well as the Way of the Crane for an offensive push, but opting just to sit back for now, get some crowd control potentially onto Chaz, and keep up the pressure onto Swapsy.
Method Black have had way more pressure in this game. I mean, they've got Icebound Fortitude already, Anti-Magic Zone, Blizzo's game swap too. This might be just him dying. His Glider Safeguard is procced. He's retreating away, not going to be getting caught off guard today. But now he left Zipai behind. He gets swapped too. We see the Abomination into the battlefield. Swapsy feels comfortable to not use the Demonic Gateway just yet to escape from it. Chaz locked down in crowd control. Looney looks like he may be trying to sit down for a drink. Very important for both healers to maintain their mana, but now Blizzo under fire as Looney tried to make that exchange, trading mana for a defensive cooldown. Swapsy now Chaos Bolting with redirected Touch of Karma damage. Nice Nether Ward timing by Swapsy. You can redirect a Touch of Karma damage back onto the Windwalker Monk. Now double Mortal Coil off the back of it. Swapsy trying to burst, gets Ring of Peace. They need to keep denying Swapsy's Chaos Bolts. Looking for a Fear as Looney looked like he wanted to cross the map. Not going to be finding it. This map was a smart selection from Wildcard Gaming. Chaz is going to be unable to drink. Looney realizing that's the only way that they'll really lose is if they let him. So he's repositioned on top of Chaz. Pressure still on both sides. In terms of damage, they're evenly matched. In terms of mana, Wildcard Gaming are significantly ahead.
Yeah, definitely. And that is one of the advantages of this map. Like you kind of talked about, Blizzo could be in some trouble, though. He ports away to safety with the Transcendence. He's going to be out of line of sight. Tops off. But still, a lot of trouble here for Blizzo with no Trinket, no Touch of Karma. If he gets caught into a stun lock by Waz, who has that Vendetta available, it could be danger time for Wildcard Gaming. Chaz sneaking away
to
get a drink. Ring of Peace, nicely placed by Looney, will deny the drink. Actually, Chaz got a surprising amount of mana there. This definitely keeps Method Black in the fight.
I think that he was hoping to pin Chaz in the room out of range of healing his team. It's been unfortunate that he wasn't able to hit that. That might have actually netted a kill. Chaz may need to reconsider where he positions to drink to try and avoid that Ring of Peace kill potential. But at least now he's tied mana, so they're still evenly matched in terms of damage and now evenly matched in terms of mana moving forward. Anti-magic zone. Fair exchange for the Dark Soul. Good trade by Z-Pi. Not getting overcommitted in terms of defensive cooldowns there. Chaz now crowd control. This could be a big push onto Swapsy with a double leg sweep. Looney not moving in with the Way of the Crane just yet. Chaz with Thorns activated. Wildcard Gaming just switch off that, immediately attacking a new target. Where is Waz? I'm wondering if Waz is going to ever swap to Looney. We saw a bit of pressure on Looney from Waz in the last game to try and mix it up, but this game he's been just training down Blizzo and Z-Pi, maximizing his damage onto those two targets. Mana still even. Swapsy still dipping low. Chaz responds, but it may be too late. Now they have to overlap. Multiple defensive cooldowns. Nether Ward on the Glider's Maledict. Well done by Swapsy. That's keeping him afloat. If he didn't get that, he may just be dead right now.
Yeah, a lot of trouble for Swapsy, but still good counter pressure here from Method Black as all three members rotting down a little bit low. Looney charges in, gets caught into his Shadow Fury. Nice leg sweep, setting up his team to get some burst damage out onto both Waz and Swapsy. And I like that Wildcard Gaming isn't afraid to put some pressure onto Waz. He's going to be taking a lot of cleave pressure from that Turbo Fist of Blizzo. And if they can consistently do that, that's going to tax Chaz's mana even more. Blizzo now with his Trinket is going to be feeling very comfortable to survive as he has to use his Gladiator's Medallion to escape the Kidney Shot. Looking to extend the crowd control chain onto Chaz. Paralysis into an Asphyxiate stun. Swapsy at 50% health. Do they have the damage to push him over? Chaz is able to top him off.
Swapsy needs to use the Demonic Gateway. I don't think he can tank the Raise Abomination without any defensive cooldowns. But now Swapsy death grips him. Z-Pi death grips him back into the fight. All these players playing Death Knight can get confusing sometimes. But mana still even here as Dampening moves in, which is not good for Wildcard Gaming. They want to have a lead in that regard so they can push forward with Way of the Crane and then overwhelm the Destruction Warlock. Mana being even is still means that it's anyone's game here on hook point. Blizzo gets bursted. Z-Pi trades. Once again, high value anti-magic zone, hitting two major offensive cooldowns from Method Black, being the Dark Soul and the Vendetta. But as that fades, the damage isn't going to be getting any lower. Blizzo now has to exchange Touch of Karma as well. Z-Pi still has a lot in his pocket, but Blizzo, this is where we can't see a Transcendence portal mistake. He needs to make sure that he's always portaling out of line of sight. Triple stun set up by Wildcard Gaming as they look to close. Chaz really under responding to the burst, catches a big heal and manages to get away with it.
Yeah, tops off Swapsy quite easily. Blizzo, though, with the Touch of Death, is going to be able to make a huge offensive push. Looney caught into a Kidney Shot as Waz makes a swap, actually just crowd controlling Looney out. Blizzo still the main focus point for Method Black. Life Cocoon trades out from Looney, but they're shredding through it. Blizzo still could be in a lot of trouble. With the fused magic, he has at least one response, but if he gets caught into a stun lock from Waz, it could be devastation for Wildcard Gaming.
The Abomination back in the battle, and Swapsy has no way to escape to safety. Blizzo gets kidney shots as Waz is trying to peel for swaps. The Infernals have landed, so it's either a race to the finish or we're going to see Wildcard Gaming just abandon the push. Looks like they want to reposition back at the wall in line of sight to Destruction Warlock. Means this is a smart maneuver, avoiding the Infernal Chaos Bolt as long as possible. But now Swaps is trying to punish with the Shadow Fear. He doesn't manage to land it. Looney gets swapped to on the way of the Crane. This is the kidney shot and double Mortal Coil. Perfect setup by Method Black. Multiple Glyers Maledicts coming in. Looney gets feared right at the end of it. He's not able to connect too many heals. He desperately wanted to. Now he has to portal back away at very low health. Chaz actually was able to regenerate mana amidst all of that chaos, and now they have a significant lead.
That was a disaster from Looney. He pushed in with the Way of the Crane, got kidney shot, Mortal Coil feared, had to portal away, didn't get any value from the Way of the Crane. In the meantime, Chaz sat down for a drink. Now all of a sudden, Method Black, they have a wild lead. Z-Fi in some trouble with no Icebound Fortitude. Going to be a vulnerable target at 16% dampening. Nice double leg sweep setup coming in from Wildcard Gaming, but they just don't have the damage yet. Swapsy now with Unending Resolve is going to be feeling very safe, and things are actually looking really good for Method Black.
Yeah, right now Method Black are looking solid, potentially 3-0-ing Wildcard Gaming here on their best map. This would be startling to say the least, considering Wildcard Gaming's domination last week. Spelllock secured. This was a win condition that we saw in the first round. Z-Fi is trying to back up Blizzo, breaking up the Chaos Bolts, but even still, double Mortal Coil now to follow it up. Is Looney going to go for the Way of the Crane? Repositioned now at the wall to try and avoid fear. They need to desperately make sure that Looney does not get feared on this Way of the Crane. He must have to use it. This damage is too high. Dampening is ramped up. Now Z-Pi is a liability. Two targets low. Looney's got one more opportunity for a big push, but Swapsy has an answer. Method Black should have Wildcard Gaming in checkmate unless they make a mistake at this point. Chaz likely to activate Thorns. There's the Way of the Crane. This is the big push. They don't deny the fear. Looney needs to stay on target. He gets feared again. Still no denial. They're focused more on Chaos Bolts, but without that Way of the Crane, do they have enough damage to push him over? Way of the Crane now faded. Blizzo gets bursted, but it's a race to the finish.
Uh-oh.
Resolve is more than enough for Swapsy to survive as he's tossing out tons of damage, and Blizzo is likely to fall. He's just going for the kill. He has 10% health. He's going for it. No, now abandons it, realizing maybe that's too risky of a race to engage in. Looney fully blinded with no Gladiator's Medallion. Waz trying to find a target, but he has to sap Looney. I love the positioning from Blizzo. Very far away from Looney, so Waz has to pick whether or not he wants to crowd control the healer or attack the target. And because of that stall, Looney was able to sit through the blind comfortably.
Yeah, and now Looney almost has his life cocoon available as well, and that's going to allow Blizzo to make a push. Double leg sweep once again onto Chaz, onto Swapsy. They don't have any defenses left. Which team is going to fall first? Blizzo's feeling healthy. Swapsy getting lower. Wildcard Gaming ties up the series. A great offensive push there at the end. Blizzo with a beautiful transcend.
Z-Pi, they get out of there, and then Looney tries to shut down the drink. Well, Waz kidney shot him and does a little swap of his own to him. All of a sudden, Chaz comes back with 60% mana, and every single time that they allow Chaz to get that drink, there's not really that much they can do about it. As long as Waz keeps gatekeeping Looney from getting that stop, I think Method Black just looks really good. But at the same time, if they get to 20% dampening on the side of Wildcard Gaming, they can just overwhelm Swapsy with that damage. So it's definitely a really even matchup, I would say.
This is really weird for Wildcard Gaming. They opted off of playing Horde and Triple Orc, and now they're playing Triple Dark Iron Dwarf, and I don't really agree with that. I feel like Blizzo sitting the extra stuns could be disastrous for him. These 6 second long kidney shots are a lot of opportunity for Method Black to actually take him down.
Yeah, we see an early exchange of Life Cocoon for Vendetta, and that's one thing that you have to credit Looney for, is that he's got an unbreakable defense. He's definitely one of the best shot callers in the game as far as the healer role. Pressure now on Swapsy early on, bit unexpected. Falling behind to some initial burst. Chaz gripped into the fight, but Waz dodges the incoming leg sweep. Good awareness by Waz to sidestep over slightly to the left and avoid that right as the death grip animation occurred. Swapsy gets punted, maybe out of line of sight of Chaz. Nourish incoming. They need to deny these nourishes from Chaz. Not actually going for another one, doesn't want to risk the cast time. Swapsy stabilizes. Blizzo has to trade. Both these teams going all out here on game number 3.
Yeah, big pressure on the Swapsy still. The pressure is unrelenting coming in from Wildcard Gaming. Chaz into asphyxiate stun out of paralysis. Good crowd control, but Blizzo in some trouble with no trinket and a kidney shot. Z-Fi has to respond with the anti-magic zone life cocoon as well, used from Looney. And this is surprising amounts of damage coming in from both teams.
Yeah, huge amount of damage. Mana already being taxed. Chaz is trying to sneak away. Looney sees him, manages to stop it. They need to make sure that Chaz does not regenerate mana. It's the only way that Method Black can keep themselves going later into the match. Swapsy, however, has already used Unending Resolve. That's a major defensive cooldown, key to his survival. That's no longer available. He's not going to really be able to escape to safety. The next Raze Abomination could spell devastation for the team of Method Black. Perhaps Wildcard Gaming can take the swing match. This would be normally Method Black's advantage, but by selecting Runes of Lordaeron, they took a risk to try and get more aggressive with their composition, which may actually complement the composition that Wildcard Gaming have. And if they lose this, they'll lose that swing match advantage. Big burst on Z-Pi. It's denied by a huge anti-magic shield. Swapsy now getting pressured. Chaz has to make a decision on when next to use this Iron Bark. The longer that he waits, the more mana he expends, and the more likelihood that Swapsy will die. Opting to use it at this point now, but already taxing a lot of his mana. Chaz gets gripped into the fight. Triple stun secured for the team of Wildcard Gaming. Looney perhaps looking to make a push with that Way of the Crane. He's got an opening.
Yeah, definitely. And I'm really wondering why Method Black decided to choose this map. They do have good pressure on Z-Pi and Blizzo. Now Swapsy positioning where we thought he would, right above the staircase, and now it's really difficult for Z-Pi and Blizzo to actually escape if they're in trouble. Nice little swap here coming in from Waz onto Looney, really looking to deny that Way of the Crane. A full kidney shot. Swapsy looking for a Chaos Bolt. He gets Mind Frozen. Nice denial there by Z-Pi. Chaz trying to escape once again, but Looney's been doing a really good job. It's a game of cat and mouse. Chaz trying to escape, and Looney being the mouse trying to stop him, prevent him from drinking at all costs in this matchup. And if he can do that, I think Wildcard Gaming, they'll be able to maintain a mana lead, which is the tipping point. Once Chaz is out of mana, he can no longer heal Swapsy through the consistent pressure of the Windwalker and the Death Knight, and that's really when we normally see Wildcard Gaming end up landing a kill.
All right, Touch of Karma exchanged. We see Waz making a swap onto Looney, trying to kill him in the back line while Blizzo is still being pressured. Two members low. Life Cocoon committed onto Looney, now not available for Blizzo. And this is why Method Black locked in this map, is so that Blizzo doesn't have really good options to retreat away. Swapsy's still under fire as well. Both teams in trouble at this point. Chaz is still crowd controlled. Looney isn't, but perhaps they can sneak in a spell lock if Looney gets interrupted. I don't think Looney wants to risk it. He may just go for a Way of the Crane. Very surprising to not see him just trying to overwhelm Swapsy. This is the risk that Method Black took by locking in Runes of Lordaeron, and it's a risk that may not pay off. Is Swapsy barely holding on? That Drain Life Clutch fears off Z-Pi on 1%. If they can stay alive, they can reverse this onto Blizzo. Swapsy holding out just a little bit longer, starting to get a bit more stable. There's the spell lock interrupting Looney's heal. Where's the kidney shot? Waz needs to drop it as soon as possible with the smoke bomb. They can kill Blizzo if they can combine those spells together. There's the kidney shot. There's the smoke bomb. Anti-magic zone from Z-Pi denies the kill. Looney tries to move in to save him, gets intercepted by Chaz. Blizz still under fire. Perhaps this won't be enough defense, but now with the Life Cocoon, the fear 1 second too late, Blizzo is likely to survive. Method Black are falling increasingly behind.
One thing Blizzo does a really good job with, even though things look scary, he trusts in Looney to keep him alive, he trusts in Z-Pi to keep him alive, and they're able to maintain a lot of pressure because of that. Chaz sneaks away looking for a drink potentially once again, but I don't know if he's going to be able to get it. Dampening is just kicked in. If there's any moment for Chaz to drink, now would be it, as Swapsy's full health, Waz is full health. Z-Pi looking for some counter pressure. Looney, though, getting soloed by Waz. Nicely done by Waz, both taking down Blizzo and Looney, allowing Chaz to get a huge amount of mana. Now, Method Black, they actually have a lead. This is disastrous for Wildcard Gaming.
Yeah, Looney is just maybe going to fall here. Waz gets peeled away. They've got the Raze Abomination down. They could counter pressure quite heavily. Blizzo is still under fire. Where is his transcendence is now the question. Touch of Karma just exchanged for basically nothing. I guess the tail end of the Infernals, but Vendetta is still available. Blizzo's trying to go for a kill. He's got Touch of Death rolling. How much damage can he get done? They grip in for a double. Swapsy denies it. Waz needs to spread out. Waz has to dodge this incoming leg sweep. Trying to reposition. Chaz is moving in to try and stop Looney from his drink to regenerate mana. Looks like they've got him in crowd control. Blizzo could be in trouble. Where is the transcendence? Blizzo trying to escape. Waz in hot pursuit. Blizzo able to now escape at the tombstone. Waz snared up by Z-Pi. Good tag team there between Z-Pi and Blizzo. Now reconnecting onto Swapsy. Chaz's mana not looking too good. He's looking to try and regenerate that. Looney sees it. He's trying to cheat torpedo, but he just went into center field during Dark Soul. Looney maybe gets swapped too. Blizzo gets feared off, and Swapsy is trying to bait incoming interrupts. Now that the interrupts are out of the way, he can get some big Chaos Bolts. He's still under fire. Maybe he just goes down. The damage is too high. Unending Resolve on 10%. Is that going to be enough? They defensively blind Blizzo. They try and go for the kill on Looney. They get denied on it, and Swapsy's still in trouble.
Yeah, Blizzo trinketed out of the blind, wants to continue the pressure with the paralysis onto Chaz. Chaz actually got stuck in the room, and that's why a lot of that pressure came from. Swapsy into the leg sweep with no Unending Resolve. Very vulnerable in this situation. Blizzo's topped off completely. Way of the Crane activated by Looney just fades now. Now is the opportunity for Method Black to try to get some pressure rolling with no Life Cocoon, no Way of the Crane. It's going to be really difficult for Looney to stabilize his team and keep them alive. So obviously finds one Chaos Bolt on Blizzle, looking for another, manages to find it. Blizzle might have to retreat or just trade out the Touch of Karma right now. Things are looking very scary for Wildcard Gaming.
Yeah, right now it's looking better and better for Method Black. Perhaps this risky map pick could find them victory. Swapsy needs to survive another 24 seconds, though. There's an opening. Way of the Crane in 16. Looney gets zapped, though, while he was trying to regenerate mana. Nice play by Waz. Maybe setting up for the kill. Blizzard tries to run. Immediately removes that Glider's Maledict. Now they switch to Z-Pi, deeper into Dampening. Both members will be in a lot of trouble. Swapsy tries to gate to safety. Also gates on top of Looney for a fear. Gets interrupted by Death Grip. Good teamwork once again from Z-Pi. Coordinates some crowd control denial. Chaz gets incapacitated on the Innervate. Well-timed there to try and deny some free healing. Blizzo gets bursted. Looney's in crowd control. Two members are low. Z-Pi anti-magic zones. This needs to be enough defense. Will it be enough defense? Looney can pop way at the crane. He's on fear diminishing return. If he wants to, he can just lead the charge for his team right now. Very surprising to not see him just go for the way of the crane. They've got an opportunity. They're holding out on it. Grip into triple stun. Still no way of the crane. There it is, finally.
Yep, big healing now, but now Looney caught into the kidney shot. Waz denies a lot of that healing and a lot of that damage. And as a result, Blizzo's getting low. Is Wopsy going to be able to find any damage? He finds one Chaos Bolt. Blizzo ports away, unfortunately. He actually gets vortexed on it. Blizzo just caught in midfield. Needs to be really careful once again. That could have been a disaster situation. Looney ports away. Waz chasing him down. Chaz, what is he going to do? Is he going to be able to sneak away and get a drink once again? He goes into cat form, looking for a stealth. If Method Black can regenerate mana, it's danger time for Wildcard Gaming at 22% dampening. Looney getting low. Blizzo rotting down. Revival trades out. Looney using everything he can to keep his team alive, but Wildcard Gaming, they've lost a lot of their momentum.
The series has been constantly back and forth, but this is the swing match. If Wildcard Gaming can overcome this and then have a Game 5 advantage, maybe they just take Method Black out. The pressure is cooking. Blind on Looney. No trinket available. Blizzo exchanges. Swapsy falls behind. Tons of damage. There's no defense available. Wildcard Gaming take the swing match.
This is it's exactly what you said. The top Holy Paladins like Zach and Rubcup, and then they instantly abandon it. Seeing Chaz come in here as somebody who hasn't maimed that Holy Paladin, teching it in, really shows that they want to get something spicy underway. Will it work? We already hear how difficult it may be on this map. If they're not able to pull it off, they're dropping down to face Change My Mind right after this.
Yep, Looney, let's see what he's going to do. Already dropping a Ring of Peace, caught into a leg sweep. Now, the good thing for Wildcard Gaming is they actually have two rings apiece, and that's very valuable as a defensive cooldown. Looney already forced to use his Fortifying Brew, taking out some damage. For Waz, what he needs to do is get a Transcendence on top of Looney. So if Looney ports away, Waz can instantaneously be back on him. But Looney's been doing a really good job rotating through so far. Still has his Trinket, his Life Cocoon. And I don't know if this Method Black all-in is going to work.
Yeah, it may not. Although, as the Holy Paladin, you do have more powerful cooldowns than the Mistweaver for sure. So if they keep going one for one, Method Black will get ahead in that regard. Looney in a great position. Gets gripped in. Waz tries to Transcendence Portal in line of sight. They use a Blessing of Protection to try and deny the Touch of Death. And that is going to be good denial and allow Waz to connect. Full Hammer of Justice. This is where we expect Looney to be in trouble. So he uses Glider's Medallion to remove the stun, escape the safety in midfield, avoiding the Touch of Death. Good response from Looney to survive that attack. But now the next Hammer of Justice, he has no real good response. He has to predict the incoming stun, activate Life Cocoon right before it hits. Not an easy task. Yeah, he just did it.
Oh, such a nice job by Looney. Ring of Peace gets dropped out by Blizzo as well. Counter Ring of Peace by Waz. But Looney's going to be just fine, and Waz is the one that could be in some trouble. Wants to get the Touch of Karma onto Looney to redirect the damage to the right target. As once again,
ooh, that's a mistake.
Looney ports away, but he's in line of sight. He gets gripped back. This could be disastrous for Looney. Ride the Wind dropped out by Blizzo, allowing Looney to buy some time to escape. Waz really having a difficult time connecting to his target. He's just constantly changing device consistently over and over. They need to land another stun on Looney.
He has to pre-fortified elixir. Looney pre-fortified elixirs the blind. Now if they stun him, he'll have damage reduction. Looney is such a great survival healer if you try and train him down. This is a mistake, though. These transcendent portals in line of sight of Death Grip could easily cost Looney the game. Everything else, the most difficult parts, he's doing easy breezy. But the easier parts, he's kind of throwing away. But now they can overwhelm. There's not much defense. Must get protection. Needs to be enough. Now it looks like it's going to be. Looney has to retreat away. Ring of Peace should deny the reconnect. Once again, so Looney has to expect being stunned and activate Life Cocoon right before the stun happens. Will he get it? He didn't get it this time. This might be trouble. Z-Pi's backing him up. Stuns Waz. That allows Looney to survive. Now Transcendence out of line of sight. And Looney's setting his team up for victory.
definitely Looney trying to escape. A beautiful ring of peace once again will allow Looney to escape. As he rolls through it, Waz, Swapsy, they're not going to have that same luxury as they are left behind. Zeepi, Blizzo still all over Waz, and really Waz, with no touch of karma, going to be feeling very vulnerable. You see Swapsy and Looney completely across the map. Waz has to reconnect if he wants to take down Looney, but look, Method Black, Chaz, his HP's low. He doesn't have much mana left to work with, and things are falling apart for Method Black.
Yeah, but Waz has a lot of defensives. I actually think Wildcard Gaming should just run Chaz into the ground. Leave Looney alone. He's got Clarier's Medallion. Let him survive and just kill Chaz. What is Chaz going to do? Looney gets stun locked. Ring of Peace protects him for now. Transcendence, is it in line of sight? Nope, not able to, but Swapsy will reconnect. Looney gets interrupted. Could be trouble. Surprised to not see him just wave the crane while interrupted. Now crowd control secure, but a pre-touch of karma. Waz expected being stunned. Good play on his part. Gripping Waz now away from Looney. Waz Transcendence right into Looney's pathing. Big mistake from Looney moving towards that. Now Ring of Peace protects him for a bit longer. Looney's got everything to survive. Method Black, they're out of cooldowns. They've been going one for one, but Looney's preemptive plays have really denied any openings. Now all three members in trouble. Looney would have to throw at this point to lose. Way of the Crane gets activated. Waz gets stunned. This is it. Looney's looking to push and close this series out.
Yeah, Waz deflects with the Fist of Fury. The Turbo Fist gives him enough parry. But after that, Blizzo, Z5, they're going to be able to rip in. Once again, Looney cutting away, doing an excellent job. Caught into a full sun. He trinkets out immediately. One final Rising Sun kick to top himself off. Waz in desperation, trying to train him down, but I don't think Method Black has the pressure. But Looney gets interrupted. A lot of incoming damage. He cheat torpedoes away. Full stun on Waz. Asphyxiate on Chaz. Wildcard Gaming could close this out, but the final leg sweep isn't going to be enough. Wildcard Gaming, hold on.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.